Dance is essentially thinking critically with your body. So in academics, you don't need to have read every book written about a subject in order to understand it. You just need to know how to think critically about that subject. Similarly, in dance, you don't need to know every position or every combination in order to move well. You just need to know how to think about moving and how to experience movement in order to perform successfully. My name is Anna. I'm a senior at Carolina Friends School, and I've been dancing since first grade, and I've been in the upper school dance program since freshman year. CFS gives us the tools, the vocabulary, and the movements from a very young age to be able to think about dance critically. So when we get older and when we start to perform, we're able to collaborate successfully and we're able to move together.
I'm Annie Dwyer, and I teach at Carolina Friends School. I've taught here for 25 years, which is amazing, and have actually loved every minute of it. With the CFS program, I guess from an early age, I've always tried to think about forming a vocabulary so that students can create and build dances together. So one thing we look at is Bartenia fundamentals, like how the top half and lower half of the body moves, or the right half and the left half, or navel radiation coming out from the center. Another thing we look at is Laban movement analysis and what the body is doing, how it is doing it, and where it's doing it, and with whom. And so by becoming aware of the specifics and details of movement, it makes it much easier to communicate your movement to another person, whether it's a highly technical phrase or whether it's a pedestrian phrase. It just forms a sense of being able to understand one another and therefore create together.
This year, I tore my ACL and was unable to participate in the winter dance concert. But before I had my surgery, I set a piece of movement, and my friend, who's a very talented videographer, filmed it in stop motion. We didn't want to abandon the project, so after I had my surgery, we taught the movement to another dancer using the film that my friend had created in stop motion.
We worked with Ruth, an extremely talented dancer who is also at CFS. With the help of the stop motion film, we are able to teach her the movement very quickly and easily. And here's the final product.